Last summer, Alberto Cruz, a 15-year-old teenager, went to Narragansett Beach in Rhode Island. One last ride, one last wave that left him paralyzed from the shoulders down. Alberto does not need to win a new van, he needs to win his first van. His mom lost her job because she is his primary caregiver.
We can't go out as a family. You know, either I stay here with him, my husband does the groceries, pay the bills, whatever, and then, you know, then we switch. So, you know, we can never go out as a family.
Without family transportation, his daily outings consist of traveling to New Britain for grueling physical therapy treatments or coming to school two afternoons a week.
Well, I noticed the kids want to help me.
Yet he wheels into school with a smile on his face. At first, there was a moment of awkwardness with friends. Then I watched the faces of students around him and recognized I was witness to a miracle unfolding. Alberto had barely moved away when the question came. Miss, how can we help him? Heroes attract other heroes. Heroes inspire new heroes. Alberto's courage touched something deep inside my students and then their families.
He is always confident. He's like never feeling down and always happy.
His bravery touched local Holocaust survivors Henny Simon and Lola Fox and U.S. veteran Ben Cooper. Soon everyone began to plan an event about hope. Alberto planted a seed and hope began to grow in a despondent community. Many heroes choose an action that led to extreme bravery. I admire that quality. But I have a greater admiration for someone who has been dealt a tragedy and wakes up every morning having to choose to be a hero. He is a hero in every sense of the word, a young man who deserves to enjoy an active mobile lifestyle. Alberto is the perfect representative for National Mobility Awareness Month. By winning this van, he could begin to build a life moving forward.